Welcome to Hale-O-Vision! I just want to say a big thank you to everyone who watched the video last week, shared it, commented on it, gave me some awesome feedback. I wrote down every single piece of advice that everyone gave me via Snapchat, Facebook, Twitter, any way that you contacted me and told me what you thought I could do better. And we're going to try to take that moving forward. And I appreciate you guys doing that for me. And again, today, same thing. I'm going to post it. Obviously, it's still new. I want you guys to help me out. Give me some tips. What can I do better? What did you like better this week as compared to last week? So let's dive into it. First up this week, recent research by Facebook says that LOL has been taken over by haha and the laughing emoji. Really, it's not a huge deal because most of the time when we say LOL, we're sitting there like this. But who I do feel bad for is the population of people that are 50 and older. Let's be honest, if any of you guys are like my mom, you just learned that LOL doesn't stand for lots of love. I'm serious, I would get LOL in the most awkward situations from her just because she didn't realize it meant laugh out loud. Hey mom, so I got my letter. I didn't pass the bar exam.
LOL, sweetie. It's okay, you'll get it next time.
It was at that point I realized I had to let her know what it really meant. In other words, apparently LOL is like the MySpace of laughing. If you do it, just realize you're probably going to get picked on moving forward. And now, to sports. Last week was a little bit short because we have a lack of sports going on in the summer. But, football games are back. And boy, were we blessed this week. There were several fights in the NFL this week. All of which were better than Mayweather-Pacquiao. And we got them for free! I can't lie though, as a Panthers fan, I got worried early in the week. Our boy, Cam Newton, Superman himself, was involved in a scuffle. And I was prepared to go throughout the week of hearing people talk about how he was immature, he wasn't ready to lead a championship team. I'm pretty sure Cam was too. I imagine this is how Cam looked going to bed that night.
Family Five, I just want to tell you how much I love you, but I really need you right now. I need you to send ESPN another distraction so that Skip Bayless and Stephen A. Smith can't talk about me all week. I don't care if Tom Brady's got to deflate another football, or if Chip Kelly's got to cut another black person. Please just send me something. I just want to say thank you for my beautiful smile. Love, Superman.
And it was as if God himself heard Cam's prayers and blessed him with none other than IK. Honestly, I DK who IK is, but $600? You're going to break somebody's jaw over $600? I mean, maybe I can understand if you aren't a professional athlete, but geez. As for other sports, Little League World Series kicked off this week. It's always great to see those cute little young faces that are going to turn into assholes one day. Just kidding. Especially love my Campbell baseball team, bro humps. That's it for sports. On to the next one. A famous jackass was in the news again this week. Guys, I told you we can't do Obama jokes. We're going to lose half of our followers. But now I'm going to have to do a Bush joke to balance it out. You know everyone gets sensitive about their presidents. Anyways. Steve-O, my man, the man that has your name tattooed on his butt. If you don't believe me, Google it. Back to what I was saying, Steve-O from Jackass was in the news. He climbed a tall structure with an inflatable whale to protest SeaWorld. I hear you, Steve-O, and I'm all for people standing up for what they believe in. But nobody's gonna take you serious until they see you doing this. So if you're really trying to make a difference, go teach the whales how to jump out of there. They're black, so half the battle is already over.
Whoops. My bad.
This week, we celebrate National Left-Handers Day. As a right-hander, I'm personally offended. Why is there no Right-Handers Day? So, I thought it'd be fun if I do a little segment where I do lots of everyday tasks left-handed, just to see how awkward it feels and give you guys a good laugh.
Hey, B, you about finished?
Yep. I think we're good to go. Let's go.
Yeah, hoop. Let's go.
For this segment, I've called upon my trusty friend Standrews, the other half of the Outsiders. Shout out Standrews, layups.
Yeah.
Look at the flick of their wrist. Catch and play. Catch and play. I woke up feeling like I was on the moon. I woke up feeling like I need a honeycomb. Look at the flick of that wrist.
Look at the flick of left-handers, y'all can keep that. On the football.
Best lefty since Steve-O. Look at the flick of that wrist. Look at the flick of that wrist. Look at the flick of that wrist.
Look at the flick of that wrist. I woke up feeling like I was on the moon. That's a bad throw.
I woke up feeling like I need a honey goat. Some niggas them asleep trying to catch me. Some bitches
Omaha.
Trying to fuck free.
my takeaway from. First of all, it's probably easier because you're using a little Nerf ball, so it's easier to catch. But I look like a drunk monkey when I try to throw the ball. Next up, school task.
For this portion of the left-handed segment, we're gonna do what we call a school kid challenge. So we're gonna take these sheets of paper, take our trusty crayon. So we're gonna first write, "Move it, football head," across the top. Second, we're gonna draw our best rendition of "Hey Arnold" underneath that. And then third, right there. And then third, we're gonna cut it out in the shape of a football. So what we're gonna do so you can get a good comparison is first we're gonna do it right-handed, and then we're gonna do it left-handed. It's kind of gonna be a race to see who can do it the fastest. May the best man win. Here's Chris's, and here's mine. Right-handed. Now let's go ahead and do this left-handed. Hey, Mark.
This is gonna really suck.
Get set. Go.
Oh, this is so hard.
So what we learned, we are way more efficient and quick when we use our natural hands. As you can see, our right-handed pictures came out a little bit darker because obviously you press down a little bit harder. As opposed to our left-handed pictures, the footballs are a lot bigger because we couldn't obviously cut very clean and crisp. Over your analysis of the left-handed challenge.
Well, to be quite honest, I always thought I was a bit more amphibious than I actually am.
And we are not.
But, clearly, I'm definitely right-handed dominant.
I honestly thought I'd be better at this challenge as far as the school part because one time I dislocated my elbow and I had to write left-handed for a whole month, pretty much. But my handwriting just sucks in general, so. Next up. Oh, the great state of North Carolina. Another day, another story of somebody that's offended by something. A councilman in Winston-Salem says that the Dixie Classic Fair is offensive to some. The word Dixie. I can understand certain things being offensive to people. I feel like it's getting out of hand. So I drove to Winston-Salem so I can interview a few of the locals.
So I'm here with the local, Mr. John Wintergreen Bush. So Mr. Bush, what exactly do you have a problem with?
Well, the other day I was hanging out with my dear friend Holly White, and she informed me that they was trying to get rid of the Dixie. And I thought to myself, there ain't no way I was ever gonna let that happen. Where I come from, we use Dixie plates, we use Dixie cups. I don't use that solo crap. What do you think I am, some rich frat boy?
Mr. Bush, you realize they're talking about the fair, right?
You damn right it ain't fair. This is some crap, and I'm not gonna stand for it.
Excuse me, sir. I'm not gonna ask y'all again. You're gonna have to leave now.
Well, I'll be damned. I ain't going nowhere. You promise me that y'all ain't gonna take the here Dixie off the shelf?
Man, no promise. It ain't going nowhere, sir.
I don't believe it when I see it.
Don't believe it.
Let's
go, sir. Go. I ain't
gonna
ask you again.
Come on now.
And finally, this past week was 1 year since Robin Williams has passed away. He was obviously a huge part of our childhoods. I've done a number of Hale-O-Vision videos on Instagram that were inspired by his characters. I loved his movie Patch Adams. It's honestly one of the big reasons why I love to make people laugh. I do believe that there are healing powers in comedy. I feel like laughter and comedy are things that can get people to escape from what their reality is and just take them to a happier place. But on a serious note, you might know, you might not know, but he passed away because he took his own life because he was dealing with depression. It just goes to show you that even the happiest and funniest looking people on the outside might be struggling with stuff on the inside that we don't know about. So anybody that's watching this, friends of mine, family of mine, friends of friends, or family of friends, I don't care. Just know that you're not alone. But seriously, if you're battling something like depression, reach out to somebody in your community, friends, families. Even if you don't feel comfortable going to them, find a professional. There's no reason we should let it get to the point where somebody feels like they need to take their own life. And that's it for this week, guys. I love all of you and I appreciate you watching the video. Again, give me all the feedback and comments that you can because like I said, this is going to be a growing thing. I'm having fun. I want to know what you guys want to hear about. It's time to dance it out.